Good morning, class. So today I am going to discuss about the phylums in classification, and today I am going to show you all the examples of the given phylum. Phylum number 1, Porifera. In this phylum, the sponges are there. So Porifera are the simplest multicellular animals, and their body consists of a hollow tube. There is no single mouth but many pores or canals. So you can see the examples of Porifera is cycle. Next phylum is Cnidaria. So in Cnidarians, a two-layered body wall encloses a single cavity in which digestion takes place. The cavity opens by a mouth at one end only. So examples of Cnidaria is sea anemone, jellyfish and red coral. So you can see the jellyfish in this specimen. Phylum Platyhelminthes. In this phylum, flatworms are there. These are small, soft, flattened, unsegmented worms without a body cavity. So you can see the examples of Platyhelminthes, and that is a tapeworm. Now phylum Nematoda, that is roundworm. They are long, cylindrical and unsegmented without a body cavity. In this phylum you can see the Scarus, and there is a two types of Scarus, male Scarus and female Scarus. They are mostly parasitic, but some live free in the soil. Phylum Annelida, these are segmented or ringed worms. The body of an annelid worm is cylindrical and divided into ring-like segments. So you can see the specimen of earthworm. This is the phylum Annelida. Next phylum, Arthropoda. The main characteristics of Arthropoda are jointed legs animals. This phylum has the largest number of species in the animal kingdom, and these animals have jointed limbs, one pair each on some or on all body segments. The examples of Arthropodas are crayfish, crabs, millipede. In this specimen, you can see the millipede and cockroaches. Next phylum is Mollusca. In this phylum, these animals have a soft, unsegmented body with a hard, calcareous shell to protect the soft body. You can see in the specimen, this is a snail, and this is an example of phylum Mollusca. Next phylum is Echinodermata. Echinodermates are unsegmented marine animals. They have an exoskeleton and a spiny surface. They move by means of tube feet. So examples of Echinodermata is a starfish. You can see the starfish, and they are radially symmetrical. The last phylum is Chordata, and this phylum includes birds, fishes, reptiles, animals, all. So in this phylum, you can see the examples of Chordata. These are there are frog and fishes are kept here. So you can see all the specimen through this phylum. So please learn all the specimen carefully and all the characteristics carefully. Then we will discuss again in the next class. Thank you.